Hey guys, Mark here from MJ Drive. Thanks for stopping by the channel. Yes, the RS is back, guys. The head gasket replacement has all been done and dusted and forgotten about. So we'll go over a few things, get the car home, and we'll check it out and see what they've done.
Well, hello. Yes, can you believe it?
It's back home.
The Focus is back, guys. Woohoo! Unreal. Righto, guys. So the car was gone for 4 days for the head gasket replacement. Finished, done and dusted. I'm really happy with it. So I thought at the same time, let's get the 15,000K service done on the Focus. So that's all done. It was actually a basic service. Obviously, oils, oil filters. Obviously, they go around, check all the door jams, nuts, bolts, and all the rest, guys. Pretty straightforward service. I was told $370 odd, and when I got the bill, it was only $315. So I asked the service manager why it was a lot cheaper or a bit cheaper. Obviously, there was a bit of compensation in that because fluids needed to be changed and parts needed to be changed for the head gasket. It obviously brought the price down of the actual service, which was a good thing. So obviously it passed all its tests. There is a long list here. I'm not going to go through it and bore you guys. Obviously it goes through telling you what's been done, what hasn't been done, just to give you a bit of an insight. I thought why the car was there, get it done and it's finished. The only thing I got done was the handbrake was quite loose. It was playing up on me. That got replaced. And also to the sound symposer inside, whether it had anything to do with the exhaust system, the actual valve, whether it was opening or not. Apparently that's all been fixed, so really happy with that as well too, guys. Other than that, nothing really major to report about the car. Car's going really well. The only thing I have noticed, if anyone can let me know after the head gasket has been replaced, each morning on a cold start I've noticed that the idle sort of goes up and then it goes down. It's sort of like, not that it's got a knock, it's like it's running on less cylinders or it's got a bit of a misfire or something. It sounds good.
Is there, guys? It's like a bit of a miss. Does anyone get that? Can you hear that? It's like the motor's sort of not cutting on and off, but it's like a, I don't know, like it's out of time or something. Is that normal after the head gasket replacement? Let us know, guys. Comment down below. Let us know if anyone does get this. Like it's got a lumpy cam or something.
Is that normal after having that done? I'm still not sure what the go is with that. See how I go. If not, I'll speak to Ford and see again if there is, you know, have they done something wrong or right? I'm not sure. But that's pretty much it, guys. Just a bit of an insight to give you guys a bit of information. Obviously, for you guys that are going to get your head gasket replaced, like I said, just Yeah, so like I said, it took 4 days. Obviously got a loan car. They were really nice to give me a car. It was all smooth sailing. What did they give me? They gave me a little Escape SUV. Great little fun car to drive. Really sort of nimble, easy to get around in. So basically the overall thing was a great experience. There was no dramas at all. So anyway, guys, I hope you've enjoyed that video. As always, much appreciated. Keep the likes and the comments coming through. If you haven't already, please hit that subscribe button. Much appreciated, and always, guys, cheers. Thank you.